Welcome back students. In this session we will discuss elementary transformations on a matrix. Elementary transformations or elementary operations. Elementary transformations or operations. Elementary operation or elementary transformations. There are six operations. There are six operations or transformations on a matrix. Three of which are due to rows and three of which are due to columns, which are known as elementary transformations or elementary operations. Now, elementary operation or elementary transformation. In that first operation or first transformation, we can interchange any two rows or any two columns. Interchange of any two rows or any two columns means we can interchange ith row and jth row. Interchange of any two rows. Interchange. We can interchange any two rows or any two columns. First operation, interchange of any two rows or any two columns. Means we can interchange any two rows. Ith row, interchanging ith row and jth row. Similarly, column. We can interchange ith column with jth column. Ith column ci, jth column cj. We can interchange any two rows or any two columns. This is one of the operation. For example, take one matrix 1 2 3 4. Interchange of any two rows means we can interchanging ith row with jth row. In this case, interchanging R1 and R2, it is denoted with R1. Interchanging is denoted with double arrowhead. Interchanging R1 and R2. Interchanging R1 and R2 is denoted with double arrowhead. Then given matrix becomes interchange of any two rows. We are interchanging R1 and R2 means 3, 4, 1, 2. Interchanging R1 and R2. Interchange any two rows or any two columns. Similarly, interchange of any two columns. For example, 1903. If I interchange C1 and C2, what is symbolic notation? Interchanging C1 and C2. Interchange of column 1 and column 2. Then we get a matrix. Just interchange C1 with C2, that is 9 3 1 0. It is one of the operation. First operation is we can interchange any two rows or any two columns. It is first operation. After that, one more operation, second operation, multiplication of elements of a row or column by non-zero scalar, means non-zero number. Multiplication of elements of a row or column by non-zero scalar k or non-zero number. Scalar multiplication of a row means ith row can be written as ith row changes to. Changes to means single arrowhead. Ith row changes to k times ith row means we can multiply any non-zero scalar to the row or to the column. Scalar multiplication of a row. Multiplication of elements of a row or column by non-zero scalar k. K should be non-zero, means it should not be a zero. Similarly, scalar multiplication of a column. Ith column changes to k times ith column. Scalar multiplication of a row or a column. Symbolic notation, ith row changes to k times ith row, or ith column changes to k times ith column. Means we can multiply any non-zero number to the row or to the column. It is second operation. For example, I will write one matrix 0 9 1 4. It is one matrix. I will change second row. I will write second row as, I am changing row 2, so row 2 changes to, changes to means single arrow head. R2 changes to 2 times R2, means scalar multiplication of arrow. Just write R2 can be written as 2 times R2. Equivalent matrix is, first row remains as it is, 0, 9 remains as it is, multiply row 2 by 2, it is one of the number, it will be 2, 8. It is scalar multiplication of elements of a row. Means, we can multiply any non-zero number to the row or to the column. Similarly, for the column, consider one matrix, it will be 3 9 0 1. We can operate column 1 changes to 9 times column 1. Means we can multiply any non-zero number to the column. Equivalently, we get a matrix. We are changing column 1 only, column 2 remains as it is. 9 into 3, it will be 27, 0 into 9 is 0, column 2 remains as it is, 9, 1. Scalar multiplication of a row or a column. It is second operation, either on row or on column. Scalar multiplication of elements of a row or column by non-zero scalar k. K should be non-zero, means it should not be zero. Last operation, means that is third one. Third operation, scalar multiplication of one row added to any other row. Once again, scalar multiplication of a row or column added to any other row or any other column. Third operation, ith row can be written as scalar multiplication of ith row and add it to some other row, that is jth row. Scalar multiplication of one row, then add it to any other row. Scalar multiplication of one row, add it to any other row, or same as column. Similarly for column, scalar multiplication of a column, then add it to any other column. Means C I, means ith column changes to k times ith column, add it to any other column, that is CJ means jth column. Scalar multiplication of a row or column, then add it to any other row or column. For example, one matrix 1 9 3 1, I will operate one operation. We want R1 changes to 2 times R1 plus R2. This is nothing but scalar multiplication of a row, then add it to any other row. Multiply any non-zero scalar to one row, then add it to any other row. Operate this operation for this matrix. Then it becomes, we are changing only row 1. How to write row 1? Row 1 can be written as 2 times row 1 plus row 2. First multiply R1 by 2, then add it to R2. 2 into R1 means 2 into 1 is 2, then add it to R2 means 2 plus 3, it will be 5. After that, second element, 2 into R1 means 2 into 9, that is 18 plus 1 is 19. Second row remains as it is, 3, 1. this is scalar multiplication of a row, then add it to any other row. Similarly for column, I will take one example, 1, 3, 4, 0, it is one of the matrix. Suppose we want column 2, in this case I am changing column 2. Column 2 changes to column 2 times or 3 times column 1 plus column 2. Scalar multiplication of a column, then add it to any other column. Then it becomes, we are changing C2 only, not C1. Just write C1 remains as it is. After that change C2. C2 changes to 3 times C1 plus C2. 3 times C1 means 3 times C1 plus C2 means it becomes 6. 3 times C1, that is 12, plus C2, 0, that is 12 only. This is our equivalent matrix. These are 6 operations on row and column. Now let us discuss definition of invertible matrix or invertible matrices. Invertible matrices. Invertible matrices. Invertible means inverse of a matrix. Then what is definition of inverse of a matrix? If capital A is a square matrix of order M. M means square matrix of order M cross M. Why? Because it is a square matrix. If A is a square matrix of order M means or else M cross M. You can write simply M or M cross M. If A is a square matrix of order M cross N, and if there exists a matrix B of order M cross N, that is also M cross M only. M cross M, here also M cross M. If A is a square matrix of order M cross M, and if there exists a matrix B of same order, matrix A of order M cross M, then matrix B of order also M cross M. And if there exists a matrix B of order M cross M such that A into B means product of matrix A and matrix B, A into B is equal to B into A is equal to identity matrix. If A is a square matrix of order M by M means M cross M, and if there exists a matrix B of order M by M such that A into B equal to B into A equal to identity matrix, then B is called, if A into B and B into A is equal to identity matrix, then B is called inverse of A. Then matrix B is called inverse of A. B is called inverse of A, and it is denoted with A power minus 1, which is not equal to 1 divided by A. Inverse of the matrix. A into B is equal to B into A is equal to identity matrix means product of two matrices equal to identity matrix, then we conclude one of the matrix is inverse of other one. If A into B is equal to B into A is equal to identity matrix, then A is inverse of B and B is inverse of A, vice versa. If A into B is equal to B into A is equal to identity matrix, then A is inverse of B and B is inverse of A, and inverse of A is denoted with A power minus 1. It is definition of invertible matrix or inverse of a matrix. From this result, A into B is equal to B into A is equal to identity matrix. Then what is product of A and its inverse? Product of A matrix and its inverse. It is always, what is matrix? Product of A matrix and its inverse. Clearly it gives identity matrix. Or product of A inverse and regular matrix is identity. Product of matrix and its inverse is always identity matrix. This is the definition of identity matrix. And inverse exists means if it is exist only for square matrices. Inverse exists only for square matrices if it is exist. For rectangular matrices, inverse is not exist. For rectangular matrix, inverse does not exist. If given matrix is square matrix, then inverse may or may not be exist. If given matrix is a rectangular matrix, then clearly inverse is not exist. If given matrix is square matrix, then inverse may or may not be exist. If given matrix is rectangular matrix, then inverse does not exist. Why? Because if given matrices are rectangular matrices, then AB and BA need not to be defined. Hence, inverse does not exist for rectangular matrices. Now, let us find inverse of a matrix by using elementary transformations problems. Using elementary operations or using elementary transformations, find the inverse of the matrix A is equal to 2, 1, 1, 3. Find the inverse of the matrix by using elementary transformations or using elementary operations. It is given matrix. We need to find inverse for this matrix using elementary operations, not using any other methods. Using elementary operations or using elementary transformation. I will solve this problem by using elementary row operations. In the first step, I will write A is equal to I into A. Clearly, matrix A is same as I into A because product of identity matrix with any other matrix gives other matrix. Means I into any matrix is A only. I into A gives A only. You can multiply identity matrix with any matrix, it gives any other matrix only. For example, A into I is also A only. If you multiply B with identity matrix, then it gives B. If you multiply identity matrix with matrix C, then it gives matrix C. Hence, I will write matrix A as identity matrix into A. Both are 196. If you multiply identity matrix with A, clearly it gives A only. While finding inverse of this matrix using elementary transformation, convert this matrix, means in LHS we have matrix A, convert this matrix into identity matrix. That's all. In RHS we get the inverse of this matrix. Convert given matrix into identity matrix using elementary operations. Convert this matrix into identity matrix. Now replace matrix A, that is 2 1, 1, 3 is equal to, replace identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 1 into A, remains as it is. No need to replace matrix A. If you write, no problem. Now, try to convert this matrix into identity matrix. Convert this matrix into identity matrix, then in RHS we get inverse of this matrix. Convert this matrix into identity. Convert this matrix into identity means this element should be 1, this element should be 0, this element becomes 1, this element should be 0. Convert this matrix into identity matrix. Convert matrix A into identity. Convert this matrix into identity by using elementary row operations. We have three row operations. In the first step, make the first diagonal element as 1. While finding inverse of the matrix, convert first diagonal element as 1. Why? Because in identity matrix, first diagonal element is 1. Hence, convert or first make the first diagonal element as 1. How to make 2 as 1? We have three operations. Scalar multiplication of a row or scalar multiplication of a row, or we can interchange any two rows, or scalar multiplication of a row, then add it to any other row or column. Make first diagonal element as 1 by using elementary row operation. Just interchange R1 and R2, then clearly first diagonal element becomes 1. Interchange R1 and R2. Or else you can use any other operations also, no problem. One of the operations to make first diagonal element as 1, we have many operations. We can operate R1 changes to R1 minus R2. Then also first diagonal element becomes 1. Or else, or we can operate interchange R1 and R2. We can operate this operation. Or one more operation, R1 changes to 1 divided by 2 times R1. Because we have operation scalar multiplication of a row, means we can multiply any non-zero scalar. We can operate any one of the operation. As you wish, you can operate any one of the operation, make it the first diagonal element as 1. These three operations, we can operate any one. Our requirement is first diagonal element should be 1. Make first diagonal element 1 by using row operation. You can use any one of the operation. I will use this operation. R1 changes to R1 minus R2. Our requirement is first diagonal element should be 1. Then given matrix becomes R1 minus R1 changes to R1 minus R2. R1 minus R2 means 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 minus 3 is minus 2. Second row remains as it is. We are operating only for R1. So second row remains as it is. Similar operation on RHS. Operate this operation on RHS also. Then R1 minus R2, then it will be 1 minus 0 is 1 only, 0 minus 1 is minus 1, second row 0 and 1 remains as it is, into matrix A as it is. Procedure is make the first diagonal element as 1, then below the diagonal element make it 0. First step, make the first diagonal element as 1. In the second step, below the diagonal element make it 0, means make it this element 0, because we are converting this matrix into identity matrix. Make it below the diagonal element 0. What is operation? 1 becomes 0. Use any row operation. I will operate, we are changing row 2 only because its position is in row 2. Row 2 can be written as row 2 minus 1 divided by 2 times row 1, because here we need 1. Sorry, look at this matrix, not previous one. Look at this matrix. First diagonal element already 1. After that, below the diagonal element make it 0. This element should be 0. What is operation? Just operate, its position is row 2. Row 2 changes to row 2 minus row 1. Clearly we get 0. Then equivalently, 1 minus 1 is, first row remains as it is, 1 minus 2. 1 minus 1 is 0. 3 minus of minus plus it will be 5. R2 minus R1, 3 minus of minus plus equal to similar operation on RHS. In this case, row 1 remains as it is. 1 minus 1 as it is. For row 2, operate this operation. R2 minus R1 means 0 minus 1 is minus 1. 1 minus of minus is plus, that is 2 into A. First diagonal element make it 1, below the diagonal element 0. After that, next diagonal element make it 1. In this manner, suppose this is matrix A, B, C, D. Go in this manner. First diagonal element make it 1, below the diagonal element 0, next diagonal element make it 1, above the diagonal element 0. In this direction, in this manner. First diagonal element make it 1, below the diagonal element 0, next diagonal element make it 1, above the diagonal element 0. In this manner. First diagonal element make it 1, below the diagonal element make it 0. Next diagonal element make it 1, above the diagonal element make it 0. In this way, 1, make it 1, make it 0, make it 1, make it 0, using elementary row operation. Next, make the next diagonal element as 1. Make this element 1 by using elementary operation, row operation. Simply I will write row 2 changes to 1 divided by 5 times row 2. Then clearly we get first diagonal element as, next diagonal element as 1. Just multiply 1 by 5. Then equivalent. We are operating only for row 2. Row 1 remains as it is. Row 1, 1 minus 2 as it is. Multiplying every element of row 2 by 1 by 5. Then 0 divided by 5 is 0. 5 into 1 by 5 is 1. Similar operation on RHS. Operate this operation for RHS matrix also. So we are operating only for row 2. So write row 1 remains as it is, that is 1 minus 1. Then we get minus 1 by 5. Minus 1 by 5, 2 divided by 5. Into matrix A remains as it is. After that, what is our next job? Make above the diagonal element as 0. What is operation? Procedure is first diagonal element make it 1, below the diagonal element 0, next diagonal element 1, above the diagonal element 0. Next, make minus 2 as 0. What is operation? We are operating from row 1, so R1 changes to R1 plus 2 times R2, then clearly we get minus 2 as 0. 1 plus 2 into 0 is 0, 0. 1 plus 0 is 1. Next, minus 2, R1 means minus 2, plus 2 times row 2, minus 2 plus 2 times 1, that is minus 2 plus 2 get cancelled, 0, 0, 1. Similar operation on RHS. Operate this operation for RHS matrix also. Now operate this operation for RHS matrix. We are changing only row 1, right? Row 2 remains as it is, minus 1 by 5. 2 divided by 5. Now operate this operation for RHS matrix, means for R1. R1 changes to R1 plus 2 times R2. What is R1? R1 is 1 plus 2 times. What is R2? Just consider corresponding element only. That is minus 1 divided by 5. What is its simplification? Minus 2 by 5, 1 minus 2 by 5 LCM means 3 by 5 only. RLCM. it will be 5 minus 2 divided by 5, it gives 3 divided by 5. It is 3 divided by 5. And operate the same operation for second element also. Second element of first row. Then R1 plus, what is R1? In R1 we have minus 1. Minus 1 plus 2 is